It is important to disclose STI status to all sexual partners.
Well, I don't have any STIs, but if I did, I wouldn't have any trouble telling my partners about it.
Well, maybe, but it's possible neither of those things are true. Let's talk about STIs. Hi everyone, my name is Sarah, and welcome back to Everyday Consent. Talking about sexually transmitted infections with your partner, also known as STIs or STDs, is an important part of informed consent. Knowing your partner's STI status helps you to know the health risks involved in having sex with them, and to make informed decisions about how you want to protect your health. But if a partner did tell you they had an STI, how well would you really know what that meant for you and your relationship? There is a lot of stigma and misinformation out there about STIs. Myths about STIs are so common that even if you did have decent sexual education, you might still believe some of them yourself. Being misinformed in this way can make having a meaningful conversation with your partner about STI risks way more difficult and scary than it needs to be. To help make those conversations just a little bit easier, today I want to dispel my top 5 common myths about STIs. Myth number 1, STIs are really rare, or only happen to irresponsible people, or people who don't use condoms. In truth, STIs are very common. In the US, 1 in 4 teens will contract an STI every year, and fully half of all sexually active people in the US will contract an STI by the time they turn 25. The Center for Disease Control reports that most sexually active people will get at least one type of HPV in their lives, and several strains of that virus can cause genital warts or cervical cancer. The World Health Organization estimates that 2/3 of the entire world population under the age of 50 has HSV-1, which is one of 2 strains of the virus that causes both oral and genital herpes. While safer sex methods such as condoms can prevent or greatly reduce the chance of spreading many STIs, some STIs such as HPV and herpes are spread through skin-to-skin contact. This means that condoms cannot fully protect against transmission of these STIs during sex. And it also means that these STIs can be spread through completely non-sexual contact, like your great aunt Sally giving you a kiss on the cheek when she has a cold sore. So STIs are super common, and even if someone is really responsible and uses condoms every time they have sex, or doesn't have sex at all, they can still contract an STI. Myth number 2, everyone that has an STI definitely knows that they have an STI. Nope, it is extremely common to have an STI and not know it. First of all, someone might not be experiencing any symptoms. According to the World Health Organization, the majority of STIs have no symptoms, or only mild symptoms that might not be recognized as an STI. That's why regular testing of STIs is recommended, regardless of whether you're actually showing symptoms. But okay, at this point you're probably thinking, okay Sarah, I know you gotta get tested, but I got tested recently and everything came back negative, so I know I don't have anything. Well, the thing is, even if you marched to your doctor's office, head held high, and proclaimed, I would like a full STI panel, please, give me everything you've got. Most places will actually only test you for things that they think you are at risk for, based on things like age, gender, ethnicity, location, and sexual history. So if, for example, you're in a population at very low risk for syphilis, many places will not test you for syphilis for cost or insurance reasons unless you specifically ask them to. Insurance might also only cover one out of multiple potential infection sites for STIs like gonorrhea and chlamydia. Your answers to sexual history questions will usually be used to determine which is the best site to test. In both of these cases, it's worth noting that your healthcare provider really is trying to give you the tests that you're most likely to need. But that's very different from giving you every test, and it is always possible that something is being missed. And then there's herpes. Oh, herpes. Unless you are experiencing an outbreak that can be swabbed, you will not be routinely tested for herpes. That's partially because a positive blood test with no outbreak won't tell you when or how you got it, or whether you have genital herpes or oral herpes, also known as cold sores. And since herpes is so common, remember that whole 2/3 of the world population thing? It's commonly considered not worth knowing if you have it or not. On a similar note, regular STI screening usually does not include HPV testing, as there are literally hundreds of strains. So basically, even if you have been tested regularly and recently, you might not know your status for every infection. Also, it's pretty likely you have herpes or HPV. Just saying. Myth number 3, STIs are all really scary and life-threatening. Let me be clear, if left untreated, many STIs can have very serious health consequences. But as long as you have access to decent healthcare, don't panic. Many STIs are curable and all of them are treatable. Any bacterial infection like gonorrhea, chlamydia, or syphilis is completely curable with antibiotics. Viral infections such as herpes, HIV, and HPV are not curable, but they are treatable. Herpes in particular actually has very little impact on overall health, but medication can help reduce outbreaks and transmission rates. HIV is still a very serious infection, but really impressive strides have been made in treatment. An HIV diagnosis is not the death sentence that it used to be in the 80s. Many people living with HIV today are at low risk for contracting AIDS, have life expectancies almost as long as those without HIV, and live pretty healthy lives. Myth number 4, if you have an STI, you can never have sex again without spreading it. Remember that last section where I said a bunch of them are curable? If you contract a curable STI and you cure it, it's gone. You're not going to spread it. Unless you catch it again, so make sure that your partners seek treatment as well so you don't keep giving it back to each other. As for viral infections, treatment and other precautions can greatly reduce the chance of transmission. According to the organization Herpes Opportunity, daily suppressive therapy can reduce risk of herpes transmission by 38%, and condoms can further reduce transmission by 30 to 50%. HIV transmission can also be greatly reduced by treatment, condoms, and HIV-negative partners taking medications such as PEP or PrEP. I'll leave more info in the description. Myth number 5, if you have an STI, disclosing is a simple matter, and anyone who doesn't is evil or irresponsible. As I said earlier, it is important to let a partner know if they are at risk for contracting an STI by having sex with you. However, that can be a really scary and difficult thing to do. Having an STI is hugely stigmatized in our society. Due to lots of factors, such as general sexual stigma, lack of adequate education, and all the myths we just talked about, people with STIs are characterized as modern-day lepers. They're seen as irresponsible, disgusting, and broken. If you have an STI, you might worry that your partner or your friends or family might think all those things about you. And when you tell your partner about your STI, they might get angry or scared because they're worried about becoming all of those things themselves. Depending on the situation, you might be afraid of them breaking up with you or even becoming physically violent because of that anger. For this reason, there are many resources out there with tips and ideas for how to disclose to a partner, and in some cases, how to do so anonymously. I'll leave some info in the description. Okay, so what have we learned today? Hopefully we've learned that having an STI is not so simple as being clean or not, and that people with STIs are people. They are most people, in fact, and they might be you or people that you care about. Hopefully this information will make discussions with your partners about STIs just a little bit easier. Let me know down in the comments if that's actually true and today's video was helpful, or if you'd like me to go into more detail about anything else I covered today. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and if you want to see more from me, don't forget to subscribe. Happy consenting, folks. I'll see you next week. Blah, 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 blah. Blah, 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 blah. Just do the chicken dance.
Whoa.
Please excuse my great aunt Sally for giving you herpes.